Glycols are used abundantly in the personal care industry, in foods, and in medicines. They've been around for a very long time, and they're traditionally produced by a petrochemical process from non-renewable feedstock of crude oil or natural gas, and therefore a need for natural glycols is very apparent for more sustainability, to reduce the carbon footprint, and there are natural glycols available now. And these glycols, they play an important function in hair and skincare products. They function as humectants, emollients, solvents, preservative boosters, viscosity enhancers. They're skin penetration enhancers and hair penetration enhancers, meaning that they help to carry other ingredients into the skin and hair. So they're especially great to use whenever using any kind of active ingredients. And they also improve their spreadability and sensory feel of formulations. They add texture and a luxurious feel to these formulations. And they also offer some stability to formulations, like a freeze-thaw stability. Natural glycols are sustainable and they reduce the carbon footprint, and they're produced through biotechnology using renewable feedstocks and fermentation, just like making wine or beer. Propanediol is produced from a renewable feedstock, the fermentation of sugars, usually non-GMO corn sugar. It was introduced over 10 years ago as an alternative to propylene glycol, and we have used propanediol for that long. And propanediol, it has this really nice sensory feel and moisturization in formulations. It has this silky feel. It helps to clarify the formulation. It's this excellent humectant, and tests performed, they showed no skin irritation or sensitization, and it improved skin moisturization. And it also produced your preservative efficacy in formulations. It reduces tackiness, and it can be used for botanical extraction, but it's water soluble and it's great to use in all kinds of skin and hair care formulations. Natural propylene glycol is produced from synthesis from bioethanol, and it's a natural propylene glycol that's harder to source, especially in smaller purchase amounts. It's also used as a humectant, solvent, and a wetting agent, like to prevent water loss in products, and a binding agent. It can decrease viscosity, and it improves the stability of a formulation. Butylene glycol is produced from a renewable feedstock, fermentation of sugars, non-GMO corn sugar. 1,3-butylene glycol is actually naturally occurring in avocado and coconut, and this is available in small purchase amounts. And it's a humectant, solvent, and reduces stickiness in formulations. It's a great replacement, like for glycerin when you don't want, because glycerin can be tacky. It's a preservative booster and a solvent and stabilizer for actives and extracts. Pentylene glycol is produced from synthesis from renewable bagasse, which is a dry, pulpy, fibrous material, the remaining after the crushing of sugar. And it's very sustainable. It's available in small purchase amount, but it's very expensive. But it has this excellent humectancy, and it's a wetting agent, and it prevents water loss in the product and the skin. It's also a solvent, and it conditions the skin and hair, and it's a great skin penetration enhancer, increasing that permeability of the active ingredients into the skin or hair. And it's emollient, and it lubricates, and it also has this nice sensory feel on the skin and the hair. And it decreases the tackiness in a formulation. I'm testing these glycols in a moisturizer, and I'm testing them at 5% in the same moisturizer. This is the control moisturizer with no glycol in it. Each of these has 5% of that individual glycol in it. This is the control. And I'll try it here. And then I'll try propanediol, which is clear. Each of these, to me, they have a a very faint, very light odor, and it's a little sweet odor. Some people may not detect that. This has the propanediol. I've used propanediol a lot of years, and I noticed the difference immediately on the skin and hair and the feel, and you can just feel the moisturization in it. This is propylene glycol. It has more slip to it. It sits on the skin longer. Propanediol tends to me to go into the skin quicker. And this has a longer slip. So if you're needing something with a long slip, that would be the propylene glycol. The butylene glycol is clear. Each of these has a different molecular weight. The butylene glycol, this is nice. It kind of has a little bit more, to me, substance to the formulation. This feels really nice on the skin. It has a nice slip, but it's not as long a slip as the propylene glycol. To me, it has a very luxurious feel. I like the feel of it very much. And then the last one is pentylene glycol. This is pentylene glycol. Also has a little bit more substance to it. This has a really nice sensory feel, very luxurious feel. I like the feel of this very much. It has a little bit of a slip, but it feels like it's going into the skin. It feels really nicely. So this one, the propanediol, to me, it feels more hydrating, like more hydration. And this has more of a slip, a little bit more glycerin-like without the tackiness. The butylene glycol to me and the pentylene glycol have this luxurious feel, like a cushiony feel and a nice smooth slip, and feels like they go into the skin quicker. These natural glycols really fulfill a need right now to reduce the carbon footprint and really serve a great purpose into hair and skincare formulations.